In order to perform teach-in using the pass-through-can software, the diagdb folder, XML folder, must contain this tiinfo.tipart file. This is the information it uses for teach-in. Seeing as we've got that in place, we can go into pass-through-can, pass-through-can teach-in. We're going to hit OK. It's going to check for that file. And there's everything all set. So the car is parked on level ground, the engine is running, the transmission's in park, the handbrake is pulled, and my foot is firmly on the brake. Now the next thing is that your transmission must be between 40 and 80 degrees Celsius. I like to be at the lower end of that because the transmission will heat up as you perform the teach-in, so you want to have a little bit more room for it to warm up. If it gets too hot, the process will kind of hang. You can just shut the car off and start it back up again. There's no problem with that. I've used EvoScan to check the transmission temperature before starting, and we're all good to go. So the first step is clutch ventilation. Click on that. Takes a second to highlight there. Click on the check mark. And click here that I want to execute it. Command is being sent to the car. You can see we've revved to about 1500 RPM. It's going to hold there for a little bit. Teach-in executing is yes, and when it's all done, teach-in executing no, and normal end yes. It ended normally, everything's fine, we can carry on to the next step, which is plausibility check. So we'll select that, hit the check mark, say yes to this. Again, the engine will briefly rev. Teach-in executing no, normal end yes, and the last thing that executed, there we go, plausibility check. So that executed correctly, we're all good to go. So now we can go to step number 2, shift fork teach-in. Execute this. And now again it's going to rev to 1500 RPM and hold. We'll do this for a much longer period of time than the previous steps. As we can see, we can just clear this message here. Teach-in executing is saying no, but it should update in a little bit to say yes. There we go. Now, the actual process is not something that the laptop is performing. It's just sending a command to the TCU saying do this step, and all the info is stored in the TCU's software. So if the laptop crashes, it's not a big deal. Don't worry about it. You can always start it back up and go on to the next step, or start the previous step again. And it also means that this software can take a little bit to update, because what's going to happen is it's going to wait for the TCU to report back when it's completed a process. So we're still at 1500 RPM doing the shift fork teach-in. This will give you all an idea how long to expect it to take, because if it sits here for 10 minutes or something like that, it's probably because the transmission is too hot or there's some other problem going on. I would just turn the engine off and try the procedure again. What you're looking for after it completes is you want that normal end to be yes, and abnormal end timeout error or abort conditions error, you all want those to say no. We can see that shift fork teach-in is the last teach-in type, or in this case the current one, because teach-in is currently executing. Still just working away there. And it's done. So teach-in executing will eventually change to no. There we go. And normal end yes. So shift fork teach-in is complete. Now you need to shut off the ignition, leave it off for about 30 seconds to a minute, and then we're going to start the car back up again to do the next step. Now that I've restarted the engine after doing the shift fork teach-in, it's time to do the clutch teach-in. Like before, this starts with step number 7, the clutch ventilation. You can see the program takes a little while to respond to my clicks, but it gets there eventually. There we go, that worked perfectly. So now, step number four, stroke teach-in. This is again revving to 1500 RPM and holding it. A little bit longer this time. This is similar to the shift fork teach-in. This is where the video gets a little bit boring, but it gives you a good idea of how long these different procedures should take. Now you'll notice I'm in super sport mode. It doesn't actually matter whether you're in normal sport or super sport. I just, by reflex, happened to switch my car into super sport. All right, and teach-in executing no, normal end yes. That worked perfectly. So now, boost teach-in. This is the really fun one. For a minute, it doesn't do anything. You'll see the laptop will switch to teach-in executing yes, but nothing's happening. Some people think you need to hit the accelerator pedal and hold it at a certain point. You don't. You just need to be patient. Because just when you think nothing's going to happen, something's going to happen, trust me. There we go. Revving to 4,000 RPM and holding. If you have a loud exhaust, this will annoy all of your neighbors. Try not to do it indoors. Do it outside where no one's around. This will go on for an uncomfortably long period of time. People nearby may think you're crazy, wonder what the heck you're doing. But it stops eventually. It's going to do it one more time, though. There's going to be a pause. And eventually, it's going to rev back up to 4,000 RPM. Any second now. And there it goes. Laptop is still saying teach and executing. Now, this doesn't actually use any turbo boost. This is done all in vacuum, but it's probably something like the hydraulic boost within the TCU, or sorry, rather within the transmission itself. So, there we go, teach-in executing no, normal end yes, executed the boost teach-in, that's all done. So now we just have to scroll down here for the eighth step, which is off the bottom of the screen. Reset clutch gain. So we're going to execute this. And this is a simple little software step. It's not actually going to do anything with the engine, it's not going to rev it or anything like that. We're still displaying everything for boost teach-in, but now it switched to reset clutch gain as the last teach-in type executed, and teach-in executing is saying no. So we know that that has finished, it has done a normal end, and that is the end of the teach-in procedure. And if we tried to put the car in gear right now and drive away, nothing would happen. The car would not select any gears. So we have to shut the engine off. And then when we restart it, it'll be ready to go.